CVMTV News to see it happen.
Takeover Friday with yours truly. I think we need a name. It's Tamizu, it's Tendi, it's Yummy. What is it?
I don't know what the Yummy.
It's Tendi. Not Yummy. Tendi. Tendi. I like Tendi.
I can do Tendi. Or would it be Tandy?
Tandy.
It's Tandy, so we have more of you in there.
Well, the I is me too.
True.
So I think the Tendi is nice. And we're running the world, for
yes,
sure.
That's right.
Well, we're running the show this morning. And as I always say, this could be a mistake or the most genius thing, but I think we've decided
we've
it's
established
the most genius
it.
Thing.
It's yeah. the most genius.
Except today, I mean, you started with a soca song, and I have no idea. I just want to say to you, I say, Yendi, you have soca pan luck, right? Because you know, say, me not, I stopped soca at about 1996.
Oh, look at you.
Yeah,
so
I'm
you
terrible.
Are literally like swinging in gym.
That's my song! Isn't it wild? Yeah. How we literally just find a place in our brain where we just get up, go, get it done, and we will deal with the rest of the day as it comes along.
It's exactly that.
Because a lot of people think that we're done work when we're done here.
No, 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 no.
Then,
we have to get on with your day.
Yeah,
yeah, the day.
So
but you know what? We do it.
Yeah.
We
yeah,
do it.
Yeah, we so, do yeah. it. I mean, whether we do it well or not is...
Still up for discussion.
Most days we do it well.
Yes,
so,
I think
you know,
so too.
And what a perfect time to be celebrating women, International Women's Month. Anyway, our quote for this month is, don't give me a thumbs down. Women are the largest untapped reservoir of talent in the world. Hillary Clinton said that. And mm-hmm. I think she's absolutely right. Even though I think we're being tapped into more and more and more, she's absolutely right. Go ahead.
Speaking of reservoirs, mm-hmm. you know what today is?
Oh, yes. Look at you.
Today is World Water Day.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's actually, it's an annual United Nations observance day held on the March 22 that highlights the importance of fresh water. And the day is used to advocate for the sustainable management of fresh water resources.
This is tea to the kizzle. How are you doing, girl?
I am loving these intros more and more every
She's
morning.
She's a highlight queen for life. Ah. Gonna explode like
dynamite.
All right. And she's moving in
reading on the lines.
She gonna mash up the place with all the good news.
Wow.
I don't know.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Great morning, ladies. Looking fantastic as always.
You
it's great to be
too.
Here. Let's jump into the headlines.
Oh.
Oh.
So yeah, I like that.
Frenchy.
Prime Minister Andrew Holness's budget debate. Prime Minister Andrew Holness made his budget debate presentation in Parliament yesterday, as we know. A few things he announced, of course, there were many, but let's take a few snippets, right? Plans to upgrade a number of beaches island-wide for public access. To note, work will be done on 9 free community beaches this year. Remember, mm-hmm. we had been discussing earlier in the year that there were some issues with people discussing no access to beaches.
Right.
So some plans for public beaches this year. Mm-hmm. He also addressed things like gangs, the number of gangs declining, mm-hmm. things like, you know, housing issues, water issues, things like that he definitely addressed as well.
I think a big one that will stand out for a lot of people as well is, you mentioned housing just now, but it's the NHT, there is now going to be, once you've been contributing for over 10 years mm-hmm. and you've already tapped into the NHT, there's now, you'll have access to a fund to do renovations
right.
up to $3.5 million.
Yeah. So, yeah. I mean, it was a four-hour presentation. presentation, yeah. over 4 hours.
Almost five.
Yeah. You know, over four-hour long presentation. Yeah. So, of course, we can't give you everything, but
those are key takeaways.
There were
for sure.
some key takeaways that, you know, people had some opinions
Isn't
on.
It interesting that one of his final notes was the minimum wage note? It's almost like he was like, let's keep them watching until
the very
end. Yeah, we're going to tell them what they need to hear. Mm-hmm.
Good note to end on.
A good note to end on. I'm sure people will be pleased with
really
that.
Really appreciating
for
that.
Sure, for sure.
Yeah. Next up, we have the Haitian orphan situation that we have been following here on CVM News. 59 Haitian orphans arrive in Jamaica. Despite dissent from some locals, the group of 59 orphans from the Haiti Children Private Charity was processed in Portland. The children who have disabilities arrived in Jamaica by boat, along with 13 caregivers on Thursday morning, seeking refuge from the turmoil in their war-torn homeland.
Right.
We're being great neighbors. Some people are saying, listen, look at us right now in our state. Can we take them in? Are we in a position to take anyone
but
in
I'm
at this time?
I'm not mistaken. I know we covered this item last week, and I believe that we are getting funding. Mm-hmm. Funding is coming from overseas to support the home where they will be.
Right.
I believe we discussed the home, but just in case I...
They're going to be in St. Anne. They're going to be with Mustard Seed Community in St. Anne.
Correct. So we know that it's not going to necessarily be a... tap directly into our budget because we do have international funding coming in to support. But I feel like it's really hard to close the door and say
it
no
is.
To disabled children.
Agreed.
Really hard.
Agreed.
Any to children.
Yeah.
Children.
And I just can't help but think if it was the other way around, mm-hmm. we would want and need to be taken in somewhere. My heart goes out to children and I just don't see how we can say no. And listen, I know this is not really the best analogy, but you remember like on a Sunday when you didn't have enough food like for your family and like friends would come over, but somehow you find food mm-hmm. for feed them.
Yeah.
It's that idea that, hey, we have to try to open up this table and we have to try to help where we can. And I know that if the shoe were on the other foot, we would be asking, why is nobody helping us?
My day has come, the race has begun. I've traveled the seas, I've traveled the waters. Once I was weak, now I'm stronger. I've worked in the sun, look what I've become. I've conquered the beast, now I'm much greater. I've learned from a failure. Dedication, discipline and drive. Seizing every moment that comes up in this life.
And tucks away like,
that's right.
It wasn't me.
I love that.
God.
You saw me pregnant? Me change gear, you know. I'll wake up myself and I go, so girl, stop it.
What's my favorite time of school? Snack time, lunch time, go home time.
That is
my kind of girl.
Yeah, man. That is my favorite time. My favorite time of school is the end of school when the bell rings. She's
snack
honest.
Time, lunchtime, go home time.
That is it.
Too funny.
I love that.
10:05. Brought to you by
Crime Stop Unsolved. The bullet-riddled body of McCoy Terry Davis, Blue, was found along a dead-end road in Dendingrail District, Clarendon, at 7:45 on the morning of December 5.
Okay. Yes. Please get to the point. Mm-hmm. Excuse me if I hear that now. I'm a fret.
Look here. True story. When I was a little girl, there was a nationwide hunt for Natty Morgan. I don't know if anybody remember Natty Morgan. And as long as I live, me afraid of Natty Morgan. And when me hear that sound day, me think of Natty Morgan. I remember one time my brother, who is, even in my ear, somebody said it's true. My brother, who is 4 years older than me, good morning, Dion.
And the brother didn't wait for
he world literally world. Would say, if you don't go under the Natty Morgan, going to come for you.
Gift corrected when you trip off camera and it catch on camera. And Arvanella is just the best at it.
I'm sorry, I'm still stuck at turn the other way. So you know, Ronella.
Ronella is like our resident.
She's a gift that keeps on giving.
Oh, that's a good way to put it.
Keeps on giving.
Unfortunately, this gift has stopped giving. We don't have any more videos for you.
The biggest part is the fact that a lot of persons don't actually know that it's not only donuts. Mm. We have our signature coffee as well. Mm-hmm. We sell what we call our fruit chillers, which is basically like a slushy. And we have something new coming soon, which I'll get into a bit later.
Mm. Oh, I like that. Don't get into it later. Get into it now. Right. I want to know.
Obviously, things are going well, though, to head to a fourth location. Definitely. Where is the fourth location? What can people expect?
Okay, so the fourth location is the first location outside of Kingston. Okay. This will be 3 Portmore Parkway, right beside Burger King, so across from Portmore Mall. Can't miss it. As you exit the highway, right there in front of your big green and white building.
Oh,
can't
course,
miss it.
Oh,
yeah. Tomorrow we have prizes for the first 12 persons in line. Free donuts, of course, for the first 12 persons in line. We have what we call our golden buzzers. So if you're at the cash register at the time of that golden buzzer, you win yourself a free OG dozen. Mm-hmm. And we have free samples of our ice cream.
Ice cream.
Yes.
That's my language.
Yes. Yeah, so we have our original glazed flavor ice cream we're looking to launch soon. So all the Portmore customers, they'll be the first persons to sample that tomorrow.
Oh, Ricky. You have over, is it 14?
Yes.
Flavors?
Yes.
Is it a flavor? Is that what we call
it? At any given time, 14 varieties.
Wow.
But we do offer new varieties.
Tell us some of them, please. I want to know.
Okay, right now what we have is our Easter collection as well as our original glaze, our flagship donut. Mm-hmm. So we have our Easter bunny here, mm-hmm. our Easter chick, and as well as our candy egg donut, and of course, original glaze. But we sell things like strawberry cheesecake, that's a crowd favorite, caramel cream crunch, original cream filled, chocolate ice strawberry filled. Yeah.
What's a Jamaican favorite so far?
Jamaican favorite so far? Caramel cream crunch, strawberry cheesecake.
I would imagine that.
Really? Yeah. I would imagine that. Just said the
original
glaze.
OG.
Yeah. No, persons tend to like the filling.
Wow,
yeah, the donuts
amazing.
With the
filling. No, my kids love the filling. I get it.
Each of these boxes of donuts have 6 donuts in them. Each teammate who's gonna eat will have to eat 3. Yeah? So what's gonna happen is you're gonna run up, eat a donut, make sure your mouth is clear, and I will be checking.
Come on.
And then you're gonna run back, tag your teammate. I want to see that high five. They're gonna come, do the same thing. All right? First team to finish off these 2 boxes, eat their box of donuts, then that team is gonna be the winning team. Cam. We've also got water here just in case you feel like you're gonna choke. You'll be all right on live TV, don't worry. Okay? All right, guys? Okay, Abby. So ready. Is my timer ready?
Ready?
Fastest
I need you guys
time.
To see how Paul is licking his lips.
Paul.
Empty mouth?
Ready.
Paul,
he's ready.
Listen, no. On your mark.
Eating one at a time?
Get set.
One at a time?
Yes.
One, then go, then one, then go.
Okay. Yes. One at a time.
You got this, girl.
On your mark.
Yes.
Get set. Eat.
Come on.
Come on, Paul.
Okay.
Come on.
Okay.
Let's go,
okay.
Paul.
It's fine. Don't worry about that. Just be safe.
Let's go,
just
Paul.
Just be safe.
Let's see what happens.
Paul, I'm it. Let's go, Paul.
Take it down. She don't bother come back, Abby. Don't bother call. Abby, in a message. I could just cheer
finish
on Renee.
Strong.
Come, Renee. You got this. Come on, girl.
Yes, Renee. Yes, Renee.
You got
this. Renee.
Come on, Renee.
Yes,
you got this. Come on, Renee.
Abby, keep
professional. No matter care. No matter care. She gone. She gone, Renee. She gone.
Oh, my goodness.
All right.
And that is a winning side. Oh,
dang. Just take it.
Let me see.
It's all right. Don't worry with it.
Is it
for gold?
Yeah!
My
son! That was so good!
My team,
Yenny! I'm proud of you guys.
No, that was really good.
I'm really proud of
and
you.
See,
I'm really proud of you. It's not your fault that you're not revelicious. It's not your fault.
W. See? Win inside.
Very, very well done.
Win inside. Okay.
What's
What's your story? What's your sign? We're dreamers. Don't care what other people say. We're doing this in our own way. We come alive. We come alive. We come alive. We're doing this in our own way. We come alive.
Struggling with mental health issues can be difficult. Don't suffer in silence. Speak up now. Do your share. The time by the Ministry of Health and Wellness is 6:45 p.m.
In 2023, Gen X's return to paradise. Mm-hmm. So it's seven directors, all Jamaican born, in association with Gen X, which has been in the game for over two decades.
Right.
So Gen X in Florida, they've been doing their thing. We revamped it some 6 years ago. Mm-hmm. And then in 2023, we looked on the space, we saw one band on the road. The great legend, R.I.P. Byron Lee, would not be happy to see one band with some less than 4,000 masqueraders when it used to be 30,000 people on the road, stadium ram, road ram.
Yeah.
So we said there was a space, there was a need, and as per our Gen X model, we listened to our masqueraders, they were in our DMs, in our emails. Hey, you're not going to Jamaica. Oh, you're not in Jamaica. You ain't going to Jamaica. Every accent, every language.
I just switch it up.
So then we returned to paradise in 2023.
You know.
2023, we had to switch it up.
Yeah.
It was a success. We then decided that in this year, the year of the dragon, 2024, pay homage to the Dragonaires, as well as Unleash the Dragon. We want vibes, fire, flair, and it's carnival. We're not going to wear a black tee. The black shorts and got there simple. Now we're going out there with the beauty, the pageantry that is Gen X's. It only made sense. 2023, it's a homecoming of sense for carnival and pageantry, ultimate fitting the true Gen experience, which is from you show up to collect your costume to on the road behind the trucks, you're at ease, you're ready to have fun. When you see Yendi and Tami, you say, yeah, girl, you know what time it is. So the whole 360. Well, we're working on it. I'll call
Marshies,
yeah. I'll say, yo, give her a hard pass, 6 hours.
Not the Sunday, hard pass.
Sunday the 7th of April, Tami on the road with Gen X's. But we returned to paradise because we felt that carnival wasn't carnival then. So we saw the space, we listened to our masqueraders, and we came back to Jamaica to say that, hey, let's try to enhance carnival in Jamaica. We're happy with our stamp, and we said, let's come in the year of the dragon.
Love it.
The 2024, and we're going to do that. We said, so we're going to burn up the road, and what burns up, burns. How do you say, what's the passing?
What
burns up a road more than a dragon, the mystical being that is?
It's funny. This is many different people coming together within the arts. Some may have the vision to see, some may have the vision to draw, some may have the vision to bend.
Assemble.
Some may, there's so many different arts coming into one, because as in Trinidad, it's multi-diverse, you know? We have different music, we have different people, we have different cultures, but we all come together in this one time to bring all together and make it one. And that is what it is a unification of people with ideas, with visions of grandeur.
Yeah.
Yeah? And even in the experience of Jamaica, I see the same thing in Jamaica itself.
Kino, when you guys are looking at putting together what you are releasing for the year, how do you decide which designers you're going to tap into out of Trinidad? Because as Chris just alluded to, that's their lifestyle. You have a dime a dozen over there. How do you select your designers?
So we have to dive in wholeheartedly, and full team has to be behind the entire project and the theme. So it comes up, we start with conceptualizing what do we want 2025 and 2026 to look like. So we start for next year, and then we kind of expound it and expand to say, okay, does this correlate to a five-year window? And we say, okay, this plan looks good. Let's fine-tune next year, 2025, for example. We have a few sketches for next year.
Already. Yeah.
Literally, as we said, we pulled on the Huntress, a section which we had in the works for next year. However, 2024, based on Monet's phone blowing up and the email box being full, we said, okay, the Huntress, let's move it forward to this year. Production, overseas, Trinidad, Miami, Jamaica, are we all aligned? Yes, we can do it. We're not going to announce until Monet says, okay, we've cleared the wharf.
Yes,
Chris and David and team says, yes, it is feasible. We can do these tweaks, and then we implement. What the thought process, application, delivery, and reality. So we think about it, we make it happen, then we put it together, then we can announce and present it. So wow, as I said, we have a few designs for 2025 already. Yeah, as you see, this is, that's 2023, right. That's Winnie. In one of David Doerr's, Chris literally worked on that backpack. So it's a huge super backpack for Winnie Harlow.
Backpack.
Chris, yes, backpack. Right. Tami is making the carnival notes.
Backpack.
Oh, hold up now. Wrong segment.
So we've been having a whole series. It was called Get Ready With Me Carnival with Chris Corio for Jamaica Carnival. The final one, well, I have two because I do virtual training as well and I do in-person. So the final one is this Saturday online via Zoom. That's going to be 10 a.m. It's going to be a dancehall versus soca. So we started from doing twerking only. Can I say twerking on TV?
Yeah.
Just said it twice.
So we did that one, and then last Saturday and Monday we did whining. So we did Saturday online, and then we did Monday by Express Fitness Constant Spring Golf Club, right around by the Hit Factory. We did that. And then this Monday, no, and Saturday, because like I said, everything we do on a Saturday virtually, we also repeat it in person on the Monday. So we're going to be doing the dancehall versus soca vibe.
Okay.
So I know a lot of persons coming to Jamaica, they really come not just for soca, because I mean, Trinidad have that, them have that lock. So when people come to Jamaica, they want to see the dancehall, they want to have the reggae.
Yeah.
Because even on our road, unlike Trinidad, because I go Trinidad Carnival as well, the difference is you have that, you will hear the... All the dancehall artists, you hear like a Beanie Man, you hear like a, you know what I mean, like a Cartel. Mm-hmm. You hear that on the road sometimes. I mean, of course, it's not overboard, you know what I mean,
right.
But you have
there's
that nice mix. There's a nice blend, a nice sweet Jamaican blend. You know, so that's what we're going to be tapping into on Monday.
All right, so give us a taste of what people can expect when they come to your class. We're ready, we're warm.
Come on.
We're actually not warm.
I'm getting the girls in.
Right.
I'm like, why
take care of you. Don't worry.
Ready?
Here. So we're going to pause over one side. Here, we're going to wind. One, two, three. Just, it don't matter. And then we're going to go back to this side. So we're learning now, you know. Wind.
This is my way.
I went the other way. Okay.
So come again. So now we know that part. Let's do it together. We're going to back like four of them. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4. No pause. 1, 2, 3, 4. What's your name, man? 1. So I love it. 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. And so, of course, we have on the heels. So I want to make it extra sassy. So I want you to put your hands right here. So. Right? And then the hands are going to move from here to overhead. So especially the ladies, them, who have on the big backpack, like the frontliners, you both look like frontliners. What's going on?
Miss, we have to keep it CD, now mine is TV.
Miss, come on.
With us, and it's time for final thoughts, but I want Kino to make a quick point that we're making across the break.
You know, make the point.
About the couples and...
About why it is, so, how it is.
All right, using Jamaica and Trinidad as the two benchmarks. A Jamaican man will appreciate a wine, a bubble from a lady. When she bend over or fling it on him or jumps on him, it's a different ballgame, whole different ballgame. In Trinidad, a revler, a masquerader could give you a bend over wine and jam ferociously. And she forgets you as the song finishes. She moves on. There's nothing to it. However, the yard man who receives that wine, he will say, oh, this is not a slow wine. This is not a bubble. It's a proper jam. So they relate the effort.
Okay. Differently.
Differently.
Yeah. Ah.
It's a sign. It's a signal.
All right. It's just that the Jamaican woman know that.
Yes.
And so she's looking at him intensely.
Yes.
For the kind of feedback. You understand? The one bag of looking.
This and the this one sound, whatever you want to break it down to, is that it don't safe.
That is what I'm going
it's
to say.
In Jamaica.
It's in Jamaica.
Safe. It starts with the individuals. Set your boundaries personally.
Okay, so these are your final thoughts for,
Starting with the couple and the dance situation, set your boundaries for yourself.
And
Male, female, set your boundaries within couples.
Mm-hmm.
Then, preparing for a fit. Hydrate.
Mm-hmm.
Don't just get fit for the looks. That's okay to feel better about yourself, but ensure it's about wellness first as you build and train for the carnival space and the fetting and the reveling with Gen XS. And then, above all, know yourself. If you are a wanna move type of beverage, that is it. Water, beverage is a safe rule. However, if you need more hydration, seek the hydration.
Yeah.
Fet in groups, friends and families, establish safe points of meetup or before lunch, we're meeting up here if anything, during lunch, after lunch, meet up here. Safe words and safe cues so that if you see your friend over excited and then she does hit you with the Celine Shalan Sunrise Pizza, you say, whoa, she hit you with the safe word, so you know, say,
it's time to find her.
And so on. So just and communicate. And then once you are ready, fet with us, stay hydrated and enjoy the full experience, breakfast, lunch, and inclusive with alcoholic beverages responsibly, and of course, all the reveling.
And Celine?
Know yourself.
Yeah.
Bed before you go on the road. You know? Is, you know.
It's key.
So like, it's a life rule. And know your man. Or that know your woman.
True.
You understand? If you know, say, him can take her one wine, or she can give her one wine. You know? And have those conversations before, of course.
Mm-hmm.
So know yourself and know your man or woman. And right. I like the situation talk, the 1, 2, 3.
You know what I like?
What?
After your, I like round table during the break. Shalan and Celine, they go in. You see right here, so?
What?
Sorry, I apologize.
Why you must tell on us?
I'm not telling you.
Why you must tell on us?
It's sweet. I wish I could see behind the scenes.
I think they both said everything that I wanted to say, which is that you have to know yourself, make sure that you know you keep it hygienic, and set your boundaries, stay hydrated, jump with friends. If you don't, you know, and it's not hard to make friends on the road as well. So even if you're jumping by yourself, make sure you have your pair with somebody. And that's it. Happy Friday to you sunrisers and everybody else in the studio. Again, happy International Women's Month. Have a spectacular weekend. And remember, be good and be on purpose. And fet responsibly.